The United States Department of Justice has alleged that the federal government plans to hand over about $100 million out of the money looted by former head of state, late General Sani Abacha, to Kebbi State Governor Atiku Bagudu. The U.S. Department further stated that the Nigerian government was blocking attempts to recover parts of the looted funds allegedly traced to Bagudu, who is the chairman of the All Progressive Congress Governors Forum. The Department of Justice made the claim in court papers filed before the District Court for the District of Columbia in Washington, according to Bloomberg's reports. Bagudu, who is a close ally of Buhari and a prominent member of the APC, was indicted by the U.S. government for helping Abacha to transfer billions of dollars in the mid-90s. According to the documents from the Department of Justice, Bagudu spent 6 months in federal detention in Texas while awaiting extradition to the island of Jersey. However, before he was handed over for criminal trial in Jersey, he was said to have quickly agreed to return $163 million to Nigeria and was released on bond to Nigeria, where he was meant to be prosecuted for money laundering. But on returning to Nigeria, Bagudu was cleared to contest in 3 different election cycles, 1 as a senator and 2 as governor, all of which he won and now enjoys immunity as an incumbent governor. According to the report, the disagreement may hamper future cooperation between Nigeria and the U.S. to recover state money moved offshore by the late Abacha. Meanwhile, the presidency, in its response to the report, said on Friday that the federal government had more looted funds to recover overseas and would not agree to anyone trying to complicate its efforts at making the recovery. It said in a statement that the $308 million, which is about 110 billion naira Abacha loot, on which Nigeria recently secured an agreement for repatriation of the funds to Nigeria, would be spent solely on the terms of the agreement and nothing else. The statement by the senior special assistant to the president of media and publicity, Garba Shehu, was, however, silent on the allegations raised by the U.S. Justice Department that the federal government was planning to give about $100 million to Bagudu and that it was blocking attempts to retrieve loot from the Kebbi governor. The statement partly reveals that by a decision of this government, the entire sum will be paid to the Nigerian Sovereign Investment Authority, NSIA, and will be used in expediting the construction of the 3 major infrastructure projects across Nigeria, namely Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, Abuja-Kano Expressway, and the 2nd Niger Bridge. Also, the Special Advisor, Media and Public Relations Office of the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Dr. Umar Jibrilu Gwandu, while dismissing the allegation by the U.S., said, and I quote, "The story regarding paying a governor a certain amount of the repatriated Abacha loot is unfounded and baseless. It is only a fiction and figment of imagination of mischief makers who are bent on destroying the good efforts of the federal government. The report should be disregarded by any sensible and well-meaning persons." End of quote. Now, a major opposition party, the People's Democratic Party, described the refusal of the presidency to speak on the alleged plan by the federal government to block the recovery of the money and give part of the money to Bagudu as an indication that the government was not sincere despite its acclaimed integrity and fight against corruption. The party therefore called on Nigerians to ask the president to speak on the alleged plan to pay the governor the huge sum. National Chairman of the party, Prince Uche Secundus, who spoke on the issue, also called on the United States government to insist that the government must explain how it would spend the money when repatriated. Also, a civil society organization, Center for Anti-Corruption and Open Leadership, has asked the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission and the Independent Corrupt Practices and other related offenses commission to prosecute any political office holder linked to the late Abacha's loot. The executive chairman, Kakol Debo Adeniran, noted in an interview that the federal government should stop engaging in self-denial, allow the anti-graft agencies to probe anyone linked to Abacha's loot. He said it was not possible for the former head of state to have single-handedly stolen the country's money.